Congratulations on winning the VPRO Big Screen Award.
Thank you so much.
How important is winning this award or any award?
It's super important for a film, and especially I think in this competition it was mostly fiction films, and I made a documentary with real characters, with real people. So to me, to win the award and to know that the movie will be in the cinemas and have a TV release, this is amazing for me.
This film was chosen by a jury of non-professionals, a very diverse jury of consisting of young and old and male, female. Are you maybe a bit surprised that this film speaks to everyone?
Not so much. Or I understood during the screenings here in Rotterdam that the young people, they are inspired by the techniques of the movie and the way it's structured, or like the vibrancy or something about the movie. But then you also have the questions from the older generation who might have children that are teenagers, and they are emotionally, I think, affected by the film in another way than the younger ones. And also, of course, it takes place in a country in Europe that nobody seems to know about or haven't heard or knows very little about. And so I think you can come from many different directions and you can find one or two of the characters in the movie that you feel attached to or that you bond with somehow.
Ну что, скоро уедешь, уже увидишь меня в гробу.
Таня, уйди! Таня! А ты Диму любишь?
Нет, не люблю.
А меня любишь? Как парня?
Ну, вроде бы так, нормально.
It has been a lot about death, my previous movies, and they have been kind of dark. So it was also, I knew that I wanted to work with young, and I knew I wanted to it to be somehow centered around love and something positive. So I went to Pridnestrovia, to Transnistria, together with my cinematographer, and I always street cast, so I approach people and I tell them my name.
What do you tell them?
I tell them my name is Anna and I'm a documentary filmmaker. I'm doing research, and I tell them I'm interested in the youth here, and I'm interested in maybe in you or people around your age. And you kind of automatically have a feel, or I have a feel, whether or not this person that I approach or talk to has an interest in talking with me as well. And I think I found that in Tanya. I met her a late evening, and she was standing in the at a gas station, and I stopped the car, and she was really, she wanted to have a ride with me. And normally I don't pick up hitchhikers in the middle of the night, and then maybe I don't take a young person, but she was very insisting. And I thought maybe it's better she goes with me than if she goes with a truck driver or whoever else might pick her up at this time of the hour. So, no, but I loved her right away. I think it was, there are sometimes you need to find also somebody who can mirror yourself in a way.
Ah, so how did she mirror?
I think it was, I had also this need when I was her age to go, you know, or you don't want
to break free.
Yeah, or like to make things happen around you. I don't think I was in the same as powerful as Tanya is.
Powerful?
Longing. No, she's powerful because she has this. She's the only girl.
In a group of 5-6 boys.
Yeah, and she's strong and she plays with them in the same way as boys play. I mean, she's not afraid. If they do something dangerous, she's gonna do the same thing. Yeah. If they climb something high or go up in a tree or they throw themselves from a sling or whatever, Tanya is either the first one to try it or she'll be the second one.
Боишься потерять? Брошу все.
Бать, там такая глубина, или...
Он такая голубая. Помню, я в психушку отправлял. А через год я оттуда как имя выйду.
В нашем мире вообще нет любви.
Ну?
Саш, не трогай!
Do you still see the guys? Do you talk to them? Or do they enter your life and then disappear again?
They are still very much in my life, even though we are not together. But now it's mostly on social media. And I tried to get them to Rotterdam for the premiere, but we had some problems with the passports, unfortunately.
Soviet style.
Yeah, I mean, they have everyone has a Transnistrian passport, but it's only valid within Transnistria because it's not recognized, so they cannot.
Yeah, it's not recognized as a country, right?
Yeah, they cannot go with their passport works within this tiny, tiny country, but nowhere else. And they are able to, if you have a little bit of money, then you can get a Moldovan passport. Or if you have a little bit more money, you can get a Ukrainian one or a Russian one, maybe. And those are a little bit difficult to get. But I'm sure I'm trying to help them to get them because I want them to just experience audience at some point and
The journey you've taken them on in a way.
Yeah. I want them to see the final and hear the discussions afterwards, and just kind of also to avoid that it's not always me talking about them, but they can actually speak for themselves and talk about me or ask questions to the audience if they have, or they can talk about the. They can answer questions way better than me.